a step too far because it's happening in all sports.
Well, it's not someone who always kept his cool on the field, Major League Baseball legend and the Iron Man himself, Cal Ripken Jr. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Morning, sir.
Thanks for having me.
So there's this new rule. How do you feel about it?
Trash talking in general or
yeah.
just the
yeah.
New rule?
Well, both.
I always thought that it's not really a place in sports. The competition is about sportsmanship. It is about the team versus team. When trash talking occurs, it becomes personal.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's
it does.
The danger that it goes back and forth and it gets out of control mm-hmm. really, really quickly. I never thought, I guess they do it for motivating reasons, you know, because sometimes in other sports besides baseball,
sure.
you need that extra motivation. And sometimes trash talking will raise your game.
Right. If people are unfamiliar with what trash talking is, here's a little bit of it.
For all you non-believers, disrespect us, talk crap about the defense like we ain't the third best defense in the league. All we hear is about their defense. They can't stop a nosebleed. 25th in the league, and we the one to get disrespected.
He had the broken nose, and I was glad we broke his nose.
You shouldn't like the opponent you're up against right now. This is the playoffs. But hey, you know, we don't like any of them right now. You shouldn't. You know, Danny Woodhead is a great kid, but I can't stand Danny Woodhead right now.
So you talked about, you know, the Tom Brady screaming at the Jets sideline, and then to get back, the Jets were hawking at them. Cal, you've been in the most intense situations possible. How come certain people can suck it up and others can't?
I don't know. That there's a difference is media. There's one issue how you deal with
yeah.
the media and how you talk. I mean, I wouldn't consider that trash talking. That's just
no.
the answer to the
back. We're talking about like
in
when
the
they're
heat
helmet
of
to helmet.
In the heat of competition, there's always going to be something that goes on. But again, the sportsmanlike, it was kind of ironic. When you celebrate too much in the end zone, they give you an unsportsmanlike.
Yeah,
and, cost you yardage.
So how do you define unsportsmanlike in other ways? And I guess they're trying to define that now.
No kidding. Last week, we had you on the telephone because mm-hmm. We promoted Cal Ripken's going to be here tomorrow unless he calls in sick because famously.
He never did.
Never called in sick. Well, we didn't specify snow, and you were unable to make it. We did talk a little bit with you on the telephone, though.
The game was canceled. That's really what it was.
Right. That's true. That's true.
The game was canceled.
Yeah,
it wasn't me calling in
sick. You get a free pass.
Yeah. That's it.
One other thing I'm interested in talking to you about, because you had a family situation in baseball mm-hmm. where your dad and you and now your children. Now Jim Leland's going to coach his son at the Tigers training camp. What do you think about that? We saw it with Ken Griffey, too.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I mean, most people think of the relationship between coach and son in the Little League sense, where there's mm-hmm. favoritism. Sometimes you might not play, but I mean, this is the professional level. And sometimes I think the coach still goes overboard not to give them special treatment. I felt it with my dad. You know, it was, I called him dad the first couple times in the, when he was there, and then I got teased to death.
Oh.
But yet, he never really looked out to me in a special sort of way. He almost went the other way to say, okay, you're just one of the guys.
Right. But then it was you and Billy, too.
True.
Now I got to talk about another reason why you're here, not only to see Steve in person. He is actually a living, breathing person. It's good to meet your idol, finally. But also about the Energizer.
Huh?
So what,
you are the Energizer.
Yeah.
Well, you're the Energizer Bunny. Actually, every time I look at the show, I think of the Energizer Bunny for you
really?
For some reason.
Mm-hmm.
But we're looking for our sixth...
It's the four loco talking.
There you go. we're looking for the next representative of the Energizer Keep Going Hall of Fame. This
yep.
is our nomination phase. If you know anybody like Brian, who's energetic and has a positive impact
yep.
in and around everybody, yeah, I need everyone to actually go to Energizer.com/Hall of Fame and nominate someone. First prize is $10,000 in cash.
Whoa.
And $5,000 to the charity of your choice. It's a real simple process, so if you know anybody, we're looking for nominations right now.
If I nominate Brian Kilmeade, although you just suggested it, could I still get the
$10,000? only if he wins. I looked him up online. I was trying to nominate him myself, but I didn't have enough.
No support, baby.
He makes himself up.
All right. Thank you, Iron Man. Always great to see you.
Good to be here.
Thank you. Steve, don't touch me as long as
I'm sorry.
Coming up on our show.